Good morning, my dear students. I welcome you all for VTU eShikshana program. Myself, Dr. Madhukeshwarayan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering Department, Jain Institute of Technology, Davanagere. Today, I am continuing sixth session on thermal radiation chapter of heat transfer subject. In the previous sessions, we have already covered basic theory of radiation, electromagnetic wave spectrum, radiation properties of surfaces, concept of different bodies like black body, white body, gray body, opaque body and transparent body, spectral emissive power, total emissive power, Stefan-Boltzmann law, Stefan-Boltzmann constant, Kirchhoff's law and Planck's law, Wien's displacement law, and also we have covered gray body and emissive power of gray body, some solved examples on solid angle and intensity of radiation, Lambert's cosine law, radiosity, net energy leaving the surface, wave factor, net exchange between surfaces, electrical analogy for radiation, and also some special properties of wave factor. These are the concepts which we have already discussed in the earlier sessions. Today, in this session, we are going to discuss some more concepts on the thermal radiation. You can note down my email ID and phone numbers displayed on the screen. For any clarifications or doubts, you can contact me on these numbers. Our next topic is the shape factor for different geometries. The wave factor, or also known as shape factor, has proven to be very useful in radiation analysis because it allows us to express the fraction of radiation leaving a surface that strikes another surface in terms of the orientation of these two surfaces relative to each other. The underlying assumption in this process is that the radiation a surface receives from a source is directly proportional to the angle of the surface subtends when viewed from the source. This would be in case of only if the radiation coming off the source is uniform in all the directions throughout its surface and the medium between the surfaces does not absorb, emit or scatter radiation. That is, it is the case when the surface are isothermal and diffuser, emitters and reflectors and the surfaces are separated by non participating medium such as vacuum or air. Wave factor for hundreds of common geometries are evaluated and the results are given in analytical, graphical and tabular form. Wave factor or shape factor for different geometries are as follows. This figure 22 shows the wave factor for surface to itself is zero for plane and convex surfaces and non-zero for concave surface. Now you can see for plane surface the wave factor, that is shape factor to itself, that is F1 to 1 is equal to zero. And the shape factor from 2 to 2 for a convex surface is also equal to zero. But for concave surface it is not 0, F3 to 3 is not equal to 0. Now this table represents the wave factor or shape factor for aligned and parallel rectangle. So this is the rectangle I which is aligned and parallel to the rectangle J. The distance between two rectangles is L. X and Y are the dimensions of I and J in X and Y directions. So X bar is equal to X by L and Y bar is equal to Y by L. Now this is the equation which represents the shape factor for aligned and parallel rectangle. The next one is coaxial parallel disk. Figure shows two coaxial parallel disks So I and J, L is the distance between two parallel disks, Ri is the radius of disk I, Rj is the radius of disk J. R capital R suffix I is equal to small Ri by L, and capital R suffix J is equal to small r suffix j by L, where S is equal to 1 plus r capital R j square divided by capital R I square. And this is the equation which is used to find out the view factor for this case of coaxial parallel disk. Now we can see the view factor for perpendicular rectangles with a common edge. There are two right angles I and J. Both the right angles are perpendicular to each other with the dimensions x, y, z as shown in the figure in x, y, z directions, and they share a common edge. Here in this case, capital H is equal to Z by X and capital W is equal to Y by X. And this is the equation of shape factor for the case of perpendicular rectangles with a common edge, that is Fi to J. So these are some of the 2D geometries. Now the view factor for a parallel plate with middle line connected by perpendicular line. So you can see that there are two parallel plates I and J, whereas the middle line connected by a perpendicular line. So this is the middle line. The distance between them is L, and the plate J is having the width W suffix J. The plate I is having the width small w suffix I. Capital W suffix I is equal to small w suffix I by L, and capital W suffix J is equal to small w suffix J by L. And Fi to J is equal to, this is the equation, that is a shape factor for a two-dimensional geometry, that is of parallel plate with midlines connected by perpendicular line. Now another two-dimensional geometry is inclined plate of equal width and with a common edge. So I and J are two inclined plates of equal width and they share a common edge, you can see from the figure. For this case, the shape factor Fi to J is equal to 1 minus sine half of alpha. Next one is another two-dimensional geometry, that is perpendicular plate with a common edge. Earlier was the inclined plate with a common edge, now it is a perpendicular plate. Two plates I and J are perpendicular to each other with a common edge, they are connected. For this case, the shape function, shape factor Fi to J is equal to half into 1 plus Wj by Wi minus again into 1 plus Wj by Wi whole square, close the bracket, to the power of half, close the bracket, into half. Now this is a three-sided enclosure, as you can see from the figure. So I, J, K are the sides which have the width Wi, Wj, Wk respectively. In this case, the view factor relationship is Fi to J is equal to Wi plus Wj minus Wk divided by 2Wi. Now this is the case of infinite plane and a row of cylinder. So you can see I is the infinite plane, and there are number of cylinder or a row of cylinders on the infinite plane. For this case, Fi to j is equal to 1 minus of 1 minus d by s whole square to the power of half plus d by s tan inverse s square minus d square divided by d square to the power of half, where s is the distance between two cylinders and capital D is the diameter of the cylinder. Now this is the graph where we can read the value of shape factor for different geometries such as two aligned parallel rectangles of equal size. So this we have already discussed in the earlier slide. So in this one, as you can see, the x-axis represents L2 by D. D is the distance between the two plates, rectangles, and L2 is the dimension of the rectangle which is shown here. And here you can see the curves on the graph are nothing but the ratios of L1 by D. So this is another dimension of a rectangle, L1. First we have to calculate L1 by D and then L2 by D. And for that particular curve and for this particular value on the x-axis where it intersects this curve of value L1 by D, at that point we have to extend towards the left side so that on the y-axis we will get the value of shape factor. Similarly, this graph is used to find out the value of the shape factor between two perpendicular rectangles with a common edge. So these curves are nothing but the ratios of L1 by W, where you can see this is the value of L1, W is the width. And this x-axis is nothing but L2 by W. You can see L2 is the another dimension of the rectangle. L2 by W is nothing but it is on the value which is on the x-axis. Now for a particular value of L2 by W and for a particular value of L1 by W represented by these curves, we have to identify the point, and from that point if we extend towards the left side on the y-axis, we will get the shape factor for the perpendicular rectangles with a common edge. Similarly, this graph gives the value of shape factor between two coaxial parallel disks. You can see there are two coaxial parallel disks, 1 and 2. R1 and R2 are the radius, L is the distance between the two coaxial disks. The x-axis represents L by R1 and these curves represent R2 by L. After calculating R2 by L, that is the value of these curves, and L by R1, that is the value on the x-axis, we have to identify the point on this curve where this value and this value coincides, and after that point we have to extend towards the left to get the shape factor between two coaxial parallel disks. Now these are the curves, graphs, which are used to determine the shape factor for two concentric cylinders of finite length. Here we have two graphs. The first graph is used for outer cylinder to inner cylinder shape factor, and the second graph is used to find out outer cylinder to itself, that is F222. Here it is F221, outer to inner. Here it is F221, outer to outer or outer to itself. Now here you can see that the x-axis is nothing but R2, R1 by R2. See, R1 is inside cylinder radius, R2 is outside cylinder radius. This is the inside to outside ratio. L by R2 is the length of the cylinder to the top outside radius. If we know this L by R2 value and R1 by R2 value, we can locate the point on the x-axis and the curve. And those two points, when intersect each other, we will get a point on the curve. That point, when extended towards the left, we will get the shape factor F2:1. In the similar way, again, R1 by R2 is the value on the x-axis, L by R2 is the value on the of these curves or lines. If we get these two values, we can project the x-axis onto this curve where we got the value of L by R2, and afterwards from that point, if we extend towards the left on the y-axis, we will get the shape factor for different geometries. Now we have to discuss at this point some of the relationships or relations of view factor. So radiation analysis on enclosure consisting of n surface requires the evaluation of n square view factors. Once a sufficient number of view factors are available, the rest of them can be determined by utilizing some fundamental relationship for view factors. So we have some fundamental relationships or rules. In that, the first one is reciprocity relation. Now, according to this relation, you can see F, that is shape factor from J to I, is equal to shape factor from I to J when area of I and area of J are equal. When shape factor of J is J to I not equal to shape factor of I to J, it is the case when areas AI and AJ are not equal. Then area I into F I to J is equal to area J into F J to I. This is called as reciprocity rule. Means when areas are same, shape factors are same. The second one is summation rule. The sum of the view factor from surface I, this is the surface I of an enclosure, to all surfaces of the enclosure including to itself must be equal to unity. Therefore, sigma j is equal to 1 to n, f I to j is equal to 1. That is summation of all the view factors from I including itself is equal to 1. Or sigma j is equal to 1 to 3, f 1 to j is equal to f 1 to 1, f 1 to 2 plus f 1 to 3 is equal to 1. The total number of view factors that need to be evaluated directly for n surfaces enclosure is given by this following equation, that is n square minus n plus half into n minus 1, which is equal to half into n minus 1. The remaining view factors can be determined from the equation that are obtained by applying the reciprocity and the summation rules. The next one is the superposition rule. Now, the view factor from surface I to a surface J is equal to the sum of view factors from surface I to the parts of the surface J. That is, F1 to 2 to 3, 2 and 3 is equal to F1 to 2 plus F1 to 3. That is, from one surface I to the surface J is equal to sum of view factors of surfaces I to the parts of surface J. multiply above equation by a1, then a1 into f1 to 2 comma 3, a1 into f1 to 2, a1 into f1 to 3. Now a2 plus a3 is nothing but a1. So you can see this is, let us say, a2, this is a3, which is a2 plus a3 is equal to a1. a2 plus a3 is equal to a1. Therefore, substituting this value into f2 to 3 to 1 is equal to, here reciprocity rule is applied, therefore it reverses, f2 to 3 to 1 is equal to a2 f2 to 1 a3 f3 to 1. Therefore, rearranging, f2 to 3 to 1 is equal to a2 f2 to the 1 plus a3 f3 to 1 divided by a2 plus a3. This is called as superposition rule. And the next one is the symmetry rule. Two or more surfaces that possess symmetry about a third surface will have identical view factor from that surface. Now you can see from this point 1, 2 and 3 are symmetry from the point 1. If the surface J and K are symmetric about the surface I, then Fi to J is equal to Fi to K and Fj to I is equal to Fk to I. This is called as symmetry rule. Now let us solve one problem on two concentric cylinders having diameters 10 cm and 20 cm with a length of 20 cm. Now we have to calculate the radiation shape factor between the two open ends of the cylinder. In order to solve this problem, the graphs which we have shown in the earlier slides we have to use, those are the graphs related to the concentric cylinders. Now as per this graph, we have to first find out the value of L by R2. Now you can see that here we have to use the value of L by R2. So length is 20 centimeter, R2, that is radius of the outer cylinder. Here diameter is given 20 centimeter, 20 divided by 2 is 10 centimeter. That is R2 is the outer cylinder. Therefore 20 divided by 10 is equal to 2. Therefore this lines which is having the value of 2, that line we have to consider in this problem. Next, R1 by R2. So R1 is 10 divided by 2, that is 5 centimeter, divided by R2. 20 divided by 2 is equal to 10 centimeter. R1 by R2 is equal to 0.5. So this is the curve and R1 by R2 will be 0.5, that is somewhere here. Now here we need to use the value of 0.5, R1 by R2 here, and the value of L by R2 will be here. So if I project, I will get somewhere here the point. That point, when I project it on a left side on the y axis, then this value of F2 to 1 I will get as 0.43. Similarly, you can see that L by R2 is 2, that we have to consider this line, this one, and R1 by R2 is 0.5, so here 0.4, 0.5. So this point and this point, 0.5 is here, and this is the curve I have to consider. From this point, when I project in a left side towards the y axis, then F2 to 2 I will get as 0.33. After getting the values of shape factor F2 to 1, that is from outer cylinder to inner cylinder and outer cylinder to itself, so I can proceed like this. Now A1, F1 to 2, is equal to A2F2 to 1. Rearranging, F1 to 2 is equal to D2 by D1 into F2 to 1. Since it is the ratio of A2 by A1, I can take it as linear dimension ratio as D2 by D1. Now, D2 by D1 into F2 to 1 is equal to 20 by 10. Diameter is 20 centimeter by 10 centimeter. Both are in the centimeter. So no need to convert into meter. Directly you can take them. It's a ratio. Into F2 to 1, which is 0.43, which we have found in the previous slide, which is equal to 0.86. That is F1 to 2 will become 0.86. Now you can see F2 to 1 plus F2 to 2 plus F2 to 3 plus F2 to 4 is equal to 1. See, from this surface F2 to 1, 2 to itself 2, 2 to 3 and 2 to 4 is equal to 1. That is shape factors from this surface 2 towards all the other surfaces and itself will be equal to 1. Now F2 to 3 and 2 to 4 are same. Now you can see 2 to 3 and 2 to 4 are same because they are having symmetry. Therefore 2 times of F2 to 3, because these two are same, 2 to 3 and 2 to 4, 2 to 3 and 2 to 4. Therefore F2 times of 2 times of F2 to 3 is equal to 2 times of F2 to 4, which is equal to 0.24. Therefore, F2 to 3 is equal to F2 to 4, which is equal to half of 0.24, which is nothing but 0.12. Now again, we know that A2F2 to 3 is equal to A3F3 to 2. So F3 to 2 can be found using this formula by rearranging, that is pi into D into L, 0.2 into 0.2 divided by pi into 0.2 into 0.1 divided by 4, that is pi D square by 4 into 0.12, that is F3 to 2 or 2 to 3, 0.12, which is equal to 0.64. Now F1 to 2 plus F1 to 3 plus F1 to 4 is equal to 1. Now you can see 1 to 2, 1 to 3 and 1 to 4 is equal to 1. Since 0.86 is F1 to 2 already we found, plus 2 F1 to 3. So these two, 1 to 3 and 1 to 4 are same. Therefore 2 times of F1 to 3 is equal to 1. Solving this one, F1 to 3 is equal to 0.07. Again, A1 F1 to 3 is equal to A3 F3 to 1. Solving for F3 to 1, pi dl divided by pi d square by 4 into 0.07. This F1 to 3 is 0.07, which is equal to 0.187. Solving this one, F3 to 1 plus F3 to 2 plus F3 to 3 plus F3 to 4 is equal to 1. Now, we already know the value of F3 to 1, F3 to 2, that is here F3 to 1, F3 to 4, F3 to 3 and F3 to 4. Sorry, F3 to 4 is left out. So solving, we will get F3 to 4 is equal to 0.173. Now these are the shape factors of different surfaces as per the problem given in this session. We will do one more problem on the thermal radiation concept. The problem is like this. A black body at 3000 Kelvin emits radiation. calculate the following, that is monochromatic emissive power at 7 micrometer wavelength. Wavelength at which emission is maximum. Maximum emissive power. Total emissive power. Calculate the total emissive power of surface if it is assumed as a real surface having emissivity equal to 0.85. So this is what the problem they have given. So according to this problem, first we have to find out monochromatic emissive power. From Planck's distribution law, we know monochromatic emissive power is equal to C1 into lambda to the power of minus 5 divided by exponential to the power of C2 divided by lambda t minus 1, where C1 is equal to 0.374 into 10 to the power of minus 15 watt per meter square. C2 is 14.4 into 10 to the power of minus 3 meter Kelvin, and lambda is equal to, sorry, this is 7 multiplied by 10 to the power of minus 6 meter. Since it is micrometer, multiply with 10 to the power of minus 6, we can convert it into meter. Substituting 0.374 into 10 to the power of minus 15 into lambda, this is actually 7 into 10 to the power of minus 6 to the power of 5 to the power of minus 5, sorry, divided by e to the power of 144 into 10 to the power of minus 3 divided by 7 into 10 to the power of minus 6 into 3000 minus 1. After solving this one, we will get monochromatic emissive power as 3.10 into 10 to the power of 12 watt per meter square. Maximum wavelength we can find using Wien's displacement law. As per this law, we have already derived the equation lambda max into t is equal to 2.9 into 10 to the power of minus 3 meter Kelvin. Rearranging this one, lambda max is equal to 2.9 into 10 to the power of minus 3 divided by temperature in Kelvin. That is nothing but 2.9 into 10 to the power of minus 3 divided by 3000. Therefore, after solving this one, lambda max, that is maximum wavelength, is 0.966 into 10 to the power of minus 6 meter, or 0.966 micrometer. The next one is maximum emissive power E suffix B lambda max. This maximum emissive power E suffix B lambda max is equal to 1.305 into 10 to the power of 5 into T to the power of 5. Temperature is given already as 3000 Kelvin. Substituting 1.305 into 10 to the power of minus 5 into 3000 to the power of 5. After simplification, we will get maximum emissive power E suffix B lambda suffix max is equal to 3.17 into 10 to the power of 12 watt per meter square. Now at this stage, we have to find out total emissive power E suffix B. From Stefan Boltzmann law, total emissive power or black body emissive power is nothing but is equal to sigma into T to the power of 4, that is Stefan Boltzmann constant into 4th power of the absolute temperature, where sigma is equal to Stefan Boltzmann constant, whose value is 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8 watt per meter square Kelvin to the power of 4, where E suffix B, that is total emissive power, is 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8, that is sigma, into 3000, that is absolute temperature, to the power of 4. Therefore, EB is equal to 4.59 into 10 to the power of 6 watt per meter square. This is the total emissive power or black body emissive power. Now, total emissive power of a real surface. We have already studied that a real surface has some emissivity. That value of emissivity epsilon is already given in the problem. That is, epsilon is equal to emissivity 0.85. Now, using the same equation, that is a Stefan Boltzmann equation for real surfaces, we can write E suffix B real is equal to epsilon, that is emissivity, into sigma Stefan Boltzmann constant into 4th power of the absolute temperature. Substituting the values, we will get total emissive power of a real surface E suffix B real is equal to 0.85 into 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8 into 3000 to the power of 4, whereas 0.85 epsilon, 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8 sigma, and 3000 is the absolute temperature. After solving, we will get a total emissive power of a real surface EB suffix real is equal to 3.90 into 10 to the power of 6 watt per meter square. The total emissive power of a real surface is usually lesser than the black body emissive power because of the value multiplied to the Stefan Boltzmann equation sigma T to the power of 4. We have to multiply emissivity, that is usually less than 1. Once we multiply with this emissivity with the product sigma into T to the power of 4, we will get real surface emissive power lesser than the black body emissive power. Now with this, I will conclude today's session and I will come up with some more problems in the next session. You can contact me for my phone numbers for any clarifications or doubts on these concepts. Thank you very much.